You know, like a lunch rush.
I was going to say, if you're doing the diaper, I don't need the sandwich.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Because basically, like, the difference between not being covered in pee and being covered in one person's pee is a big deal. But being covered in one person's pee and two person's pee, not that much of a deal.
Yeah, you're already at the, you've already reached a pee, you know, quota.
The first time is shocking. Second time, you pretty much
might as well keep peeing on
that. Reminds me of a horrible frat party. But anyway, so,
being in the business and, you know, not necessarily saying, you know, well, I mean, I guess you do know the trials and tribulations. Having twins, do you guys ever consider getting them into acting? You know, because
they already are.
There you go.
Yeah, they booked their first commercial.
Hey,
they did a Hyundai commercial.
Finally.
Yeah.
Starting to pay for themselves.
That's what I'm saying.
About time.
They got a Hyundai commercial, and then Jade and my son booked a couple voiceovers.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Yeah.
How does a baby book a voiceover? How old is he now?
No,
a baby Oh, you have an oversight. I'm sorry. All right. Wow. Okay.
Carl fell asleep again, guys.
No, I didn't know you had an oversight. You were talking about twins. I mean, okay.
But, No. Well, because I know with the with twins, you know, they'll double up. That's how the Olsen twins got their start.
Yeah.
You know,
are
they both of them playing one child.
Boys. Well, because identical boys. Yeah. Oh,
wow. Yeah, because there are limits to the amount of hours they let a child work.
Absolutely. Yeah, babies can work about 2 hours, 2 hours and 10 minutes or something.
But
and
two babies can work
4 hours and 20 minutes.
There you go.
Wow.
I have a twin sister. I'm a twin. I have a twin sister.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we were born in 83. So, like,
you guys ever hooked up or anything?
Not that I haven't. Well, no,
this
repressed.
Is the All Man It's Awful podcast.
Yeah. Just, like,
not since the last.
If we did,
did you see Carl's face? Like, that was the worst thing he's ever heard.
If we did, I've repressed it.
It seemed like a real question came out of nowhere.
No, yeah. It's a valid question. I guess it's a valid question.
Kentucky. Yeah.
You know. No, we were in Iowa at the time, but still
it's kind of like fucking yourself. It wouldn't be that big of a deal.
It's a big deal.
Like, no, it would change family dynamics real quick.
Thanksgiving is going to be really awkward.
We have a lot to talk about. No, I don't think anything
Where you
improper.
From?
Iowa and Kentucky.
And I asked that question.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
I'm not saying it's invalid, you know.
It makes it funnier that you're from Kentucky and
sure.
I asked that.
So, yeah. No, I
By
mean,
the way, I wonder if they really do have like a higher rate or if that's just some urban legend that became a joke.
I think it's more of a stereotype because as we recently were reminded through the news or for a lot of people learning the first time, Rudolph Giuliani's first wife was also his first cousin.
Oh.
There you go.
So, yeah, cousin fucking goes all the way up to New York City.
And you know, the president himself has like some unusual comments about his daughter. So, hey, he thinks she's hot.
Right. Yeah. In today's day and age, it's always a valid question. But the answer is no.
I wouldn't believe in stereotypes. If Asian women weren't so bad at driving.
So you're saying they're ruining it for everybody.
Well, basically. No, they're basically, it's hard to say stereotypes aren't true with that one being so true.
If that is true, what else must be true?
Yeah. I'm just saying.
I've almost been run over so many times.
You can't tell me that one. I don't care what's going on in this today's world. You're not allowed to say things. I have had so many bad experiences on the road where I turn it is an Asian woman.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. If that gets me in a lot of trouble, then I don't fucking...
It didn't help that they're all playing the violin at the same time.
Yeah, that's exactly... Yeah, you know, it didn't help that they were like, you know, insane gymnasts and they're doing, you know...
Doing math equations on a chalkboard while they're driving. But.
Just Matt Damon, Goodwill Hunting size equations on the window and the condensation. You know.
It's all true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we probably need to wrap it up here. So I don't know where else to go after that. No, but we are running out of time. So
fucking you know, Carl.
Shit, man. Okay, we're gonna segue and pivot and change lanes and change gears, move directions. No, so now anyways, but where else how else can people find you, follow you. Who do you have on your next Comedy Rocks, all that?
The next, when is this released?
Today.
We'll okay.
Tomorrow.
Or tomorrow, yeah.
Okay. This coming Thursday, June 21st, we have arguably one of the best lineups I've ever had on Comedy Rocks.
Why don't you walk us through the concept real quick?
Oh, so, yeah, do that. Yeah,
yeah, Comedy Rocks is a show that started at the Hollywood Improv on Melrose, and it ran there from 2011 to 2016. And then I had an opportunity to go to a larger room, and we had been turning away somewhere in the neighborhood of 50 to 75 people at the door every week anyway, or not every week, every month. It was a monthly show back then. And I was, you know, I always hated that. I hate turning away someone that can't wait to be at my show.
Yeah.
And so, you know, the Hollywood Improv's room is like 210. And the main room at the Comedy Store is 380, so it was just, you know, it just made sense. And the Comedy Store is just having such a boom right now. The Comedy Store hasn't been this hot since Robin Williams and Whoopi Goldberg were there. It's unbelievable. All three rooms sold out every night. It's on fire right now. And so it just made sense. And now, instead of being a monthly show, it's every other week. So it's twice a month. Once in a while, three times a month if there's three Thursdays. And it's at 8:30.
There's usually four Thursdays every month, but...
What did I say?
Well, you said, well, you say if there's three Thursdays in a month, you do three Thursdays.
No, you didn't hear me.
I see what you're saying.
Yeah, if there's five, I do three.
Gotcha, sorry.
So, fucking calendar guy over here, the calendar Nazi. He's like, just so you know, there's 28 days in February.
Someone's not an Asian woman.
So, so basically, It's a really fun show. It's nothing but, you know, no joke names on the show. This show, this coming Thursday, the 21st, 8:30 p.m., Comedy Store. Get tickets at, I think it's thecomedystore.com. We have Nick Kroll, Natasha Leggero, Mark Maron, Garfunkel and Oates, Todd Barry, and then a special guest. I can't say who he is, but he's a very, very big director. I'll just leave it at that. And then I have Lucas
Guillermo
Seeley.
Del Toro.
Yeah. Can you imagine?
Steven Spielberg. Yeah. Woody Allen. What?
Woody Allen. But who else is really on the bill?
It's the director of Milk Money with Ed Harris and
Melanie Griffith.
Melanie Griffith.
Oh, you had a cool story about Curly Sue.
Yeah, who directed Curly Sue?
Who did direct Curly Sue?
John Hughes.
Oh, right.
Are you sure?
Yes, I have a book about John Hughes.
I know he wrote it. Are you sure he directed it?
Yeah, I'm obsessed with John Hughes, even though that movie sucked. Yeah.
Well, the funny story about that movie is back in the VHS days, my mom was famous for, you know, there was no cell phone. So, you know, you didn't. If your kids were home alone with the older sister or a babysitter, you heard from your mom maybe once while she was out. Now you can hear from your mom six times in an hour, right? But back then, like, she might call from a payphone or a grocery store and just check in. And so my mom would be famous for leaving for like four errands, and one of the errands would be to stop at a VHS store, you know, at a VHS rental and get us a couple movies for the weekend. And we would, when she'd check in with us, we'd be like, "Mom, where have you gone so far?" "Oh, I've already been to Target, and I've already been to Schnucks, the grocery store, and I've been here. I'm going to go to Blockbuster after this." And we're like, "Oh, wait, Mom." And we lived 1 mile from Blockbuster. We would beg her, beyond beg her, and say, "Could you pick us up and take us to Blockbuster?" Because we wanted to pick out the movie, right? And she'd be like, "Oh, yeah, 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 I'll get you." And she'd just forget. Aww. She'd go to Blockbuster, and we don't know why, but there's two movies that my mom would get over and over and over, and she would never remember that she had already gotten it for us before.
Curly Sue and Quadrophenia.
No, it was
Eraserhead.
Curly Sue and Lolita. No, it was Curly Sue and Girls Just Want to Have Fun.
What?
So I know those movies so well, like the back of my hand. Like, hilarious. I could tell you every line coming in those two movies. Wow. And and one more. What was that one? Natty.
Oh, the Journey of Natty Gann.
I know that one very well too. Yeah, wow. Journey of Natty. Was John Cusack in that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Meredith Salinger, who's now Patton Oswalt's wife.
That's her.
Big role, yeah.
She's like she's Natty Gann?
Yeah. Huh. Yeah.
Really? Oh, I didn't know
like
that.
Rain Man for this shit, yeah.
Dude, how cool is Patton, by the way?
Yeah.
Dude, he's been doing my show lately, too, and he's just the coolest guy.
Yeah.
Literally, if I had to make my top five nicest people in Hollywood, it's Henry Winkler, number one.
Huh.
Not even a question. Adam Sandler. Kevin Nealon. Patton Oswalt. And God, I'm doing all dudes. I guess I should probably throw like a woman in there. Dude's like, well,
Tom.
No,
Hanks
no, that wasn't. Yeah, I'll just shut up.
Tom Hanks has played a woman.
Yeah, that's it. I haven't met Tom though. I don't know Tom. Just trying to think of like people that I've met.
His kid's cool.
Worked with. You know what? I'm staring at a picture of Robin Williams. I only met him once, but he was. He was really nice. He was really nice. Yeah, he's a cool guy. Some in the backstage at the UCB. He was a cool cat.
Nice.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Well, and real quick, while we're talking about movies, and since we're running out of time, why don't you tell us a little bit about Sisters?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's actually called Sister.
Sorry.
It's all good. And it's
save the S for the sequel.
Yeah, exactly. Nice. If you type in Sisters, you're going to get the Amy Poehler, Tina Fey movie. Right. So this one's called Sister. It's directed by David Lasher. I don't know if you guys remember him. He was... how do you say that girl's name on Blossom? Mayim Bialik.
Bialik.
Yeah.
His girlfriend, or her boyfriend on Blossom. I don't know if you remember him. He was also on, I don't know, a ton of, like, just teen shows. He was in all those heartthrob magazines in the 90s. Now he directs movies. He's really good. Reed Scott is in it. Do you know Reed Scott from Veep?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Reed Scott, Barbara Hershey, John Haird. I think it's John Haird's last movie, actually.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
And I'm missing some people. There's so many awesome people in it that you would definitely know.
Ileana Douglas. Acceptance speech.
Yeah, Ileana Douglas is in it, too. It's a movie. It's a mental health movie about, you know, whether or not you should put kids on psychotropic drugs or get them real help like yoga and nutrition and stuff like that. And it's really good. It's a drama, but I'm like the funny guy in it. I'm like the lead's best friend, and I'm always fucking around and joining every scene.
You're dropping pills on kids.
Yeah, exactly.
Here, take this.
Hey, you want these?
All right, cool, man. And so people can find that on iTunes. And
yeah, that's on iTunes. Showtime. Yeah, yeah. And I'll be on season 2 of Corporate. That's coming out soon. I think maybe this fall or something.
Great.
So yeah, man, it's been a good year, and I'm gonna go to Beirut. Yep. Doing
stand-up.
Yeah,
what's up with that?
Doing stand up. Say what?
Anybody in Lebanon, check that out.
Yeah,
swing by.
It's gonna be there.
A huge Lebanese fan base. Yeah.
July 20th through 22nd. It's this thing called the Hollywood Pop Up Comedy Club. This guy Ron Sinkowski produces it. It's a second time we've done it in Beirut. We just did it in April. It was Jamie Kennedy, Harlan Williams, and myself, and we had a blast.
Well, that guy goes a long way to have a room.
Yeah, no, but it's fun. It's fun, and we're doing it again. And I think we just landed a really big A-lister, but I don't want to say yet because I don't know till Wednesday. So
I think Carl's busy.
Yeah, sorry, Carl cannot make it.
Sorry, guys.
Yeah, not me. All right. Well, hey, man. And do you have a website that you can refer people to?
Just go to my social media. Twitter and Instagram are both The Skylar Stone. And Skylar spelled S-K-Y-L-E-R.
All right. Awesome, man. Right. Well, hey, it's been a blast. And we want to thank you for coming out and doing the show, Skylar Stone, ladies and gentlemen.
Skylar Stone.
Before we get out here, as always, again, I'm Carl Koslowski.
Kevin Corcoran.
And Dr. David Robinson.
And you've just been awful.